What's up, beautiful people of the internet? Today we are reacting to Memes by Al Volume 3. Be warned, these are dark jokes. Al went crazy on the last one, so get ready, guys. We got a rocky road ahead of us. Let's go.
3, 2, 1.
This is an experience. Honestly, kind of a banger.
Hey man, who's this?
Honestly, I would listen to that remix. That remix sounded beautiful.
Hey, this is Jimmy. He's a little socially awkward, but he's a good guy. Nice to meet you, Jimmy. Likewise, how's your day? Honestly, it's not too good. My mom just passed away, so...
Jimmy, what the hell?
Oh my, are you serious? Come on, guys.
That was not the right moment to do that, Jimmy.
But his mom died. That's a bra moment.
Oh my god.
Wow. Jimmy, how dare you?
Jimmy, you need to apologize.
I feel like this one's just Twitch chat IRL. It's like, oh, bruh, poggers, L, W, dog. Can you imagine if you could only communicate in normal Twitch speak? That would be really hard. Oh, he should have said F. Jimmy, that's not a bra moment. That's F to pay respects. You should have just said F. Come on, bro. Do you even Twitch chat? Get the fuck out of here,
Jimmy. Hell no. You guys are sensitive as hell.
Hey, asshole. She fell off a cliff, man.
Yeah, and she should have had feather falling.
Jimmy, take it back. Jimmy. I mean, I'm just saying, Jimmy, she should have had a totem on undying, if anything. Like, why do you leave your house without a totem of undying? Grandma's clearly just a casual. What a dork. Leave the house without totem of undying? Loser. Whoa. That's so true. I hate that. Do you guys, like, that's, I think, one of the main reasons I lost interest in all those shows. It made me so mad, dude. It made me so mad. All those shows that just give you these sob stories, and they started to do that at the Olympics, and I was like, dude, I don't care that their hamster died when they were fucking 3, and that's why they started gymnastics. I just want to see people fly through the air with flagrant disregard for the laws of physics or their own safety. I want to see them fly. I don't care about their emotional well-being. I don't care that they had a pet snake when they were 7, and it escaped and bit their mom and she died, and they always wish they could have done a backflip or some shit so they could stop the snake, and that's why they're in gymnastics. I just want to see this craziness. Stop it. What are you doing? This song's a banger. Oh, if they can be shot out of a cannon, there'll be improvements. I don't know why I like this one, but it's so... Oh, dude, that's sick. They had the coffin ready for him. Was it... They could just throw him right on top of the other guy in the coffin. 2 for 1. Half the price. That's a good deal. That is a Costco moment. Beautiful. You're at a funeral already. Best time to die. Toss him on top of the other guy. Bury him in the same plot of land. Don't even have to buy a second coffin. All your loved ones are there already. Honestly, kind of the most optimal time to die for everybody's sake, yeah? Oh, what the hell? That's messed up, G. Okay, that joke was like, without joke, I didn't actually get it until right when I started laughing. That's so funny. That is so funny. Pansexual? Dog. That's a dangerous sexual to be. If you're attracted to pans, hopefully you're not, like, getting it on when they're on high heat. Because you're going to get burned, dude. Good luck. Good luck.
I need everyone to take out their textbooks and turn to page 18. We will be-
Vex, you don't get it. They're pansexual. They're sexually attracted to pans. So then your dad's like, oh, that's why the eggs taste as salty. You get it?
Eating How to Kill a Mockingbird today. Also, the study I gave to you last night was for a grade.
Hey, man, these lights look pretty good.
For real, bro. Check out these colors.
Okay. Alright. Hey, man, this look pretty good, man.
Whoa!
Where your clothes at?
Hey, so, I just heard this amazing...
But to be fair, that is, like, the move. Guys, ladies, I'ma tell you the frat boy playbook. I'ma tell you, so you can be prepared. This is the playbook. You're at a party. lower floor. You say, hey, you want to see my goldfish? You get to the room. There's no goldfish. They just wanted you in the room. Or they say, hey, you want to see my twinkle lights? They're in my room. They're in my bedroom. On my bed. You have to actually lay on the bed to see up and see the twinkle lights. I'm just saying. I'm not saying you have to say no, but they want you in the room. That's the move. This is the move. This is the move. Every college dorm, every frat boy, this is the move. I'm telling you.
Put your clothes in.
Hey,
yeah, Seth. Jesse's like, where's the yolk in these eggs? There's no yolk in these eggs. Why is there only whites in these eggs? Are we bodybuilders now? Are we trying to up our protein intake? And the pansexual says, yes, actually. I am significantly upping our protein intake. I got you.
Oh, I just heard this amazing song, and so I decided I'd learn it on the piano. Basically, it's all about LGBTQ rights and what being gay is like in America. And it has, like, it has an amazing message. So, It just speaks a lot to me, so...
Dude, his eyebrows are speaking to me. Those are the nicest eyebrows I've ever seen. You could ski on these bitches. Like, look at these eyebrows. These are coiffed. These are thick. These are optimal eyebrows if I've ever damn well seen them. This is what I would choose for my me character. These eyebrows are so good that they're fucking unlockable. Like, you have to pay coins, though. Like, these are the type of eyebrows that your custom character only gets if you pay, like... 4 weeks worth of grinding in-game currency to get. Like, look at these. These brows are beautiful. I'm jealous. If this song, can you make a song about how to do your eyebrows? How to grow significant eyebrows? Look at these pasty-ass ginger eyebrows. These are nothing compared to these beauts. These are absolute beauts.
I thought that I'd play it for you guys in celebration of Pride Month. So,
here goes. I feel like this is going nowhere good, though.
Actually, I might mess up a lot. Like, I'm not that good at piano, so.
Oh no. That bush was fat. I mean, especially guys, like if I put this, watch this. Watch this. I'm gonna put this at you guys don't understand. And that dryad thick though. That is that a real, is that a bushy? You guys have heard of a bussy? That's a bushy. Groot says, hey yo, what that bushy do? That, I mean, honestly, that was kind of gyrating though. Oh no. Uh-oh. Oh no. 20,000 damn bitches on the island. 20,000 damn bitches going private. True. I don't know what it is when you like when you get your when you spot your homie a drink at a bar. It's like the. It's like it bonds you somehow. It just bonds you at some level, especially if you're like a little tipsy already for some reason. You're like, you're paying for me to have a liquidly lubricated good time. You're a real friend. It's weird.
Hey, Dad. What's going on, man? I'm upset with you and Mommy.
About what?
You guys went to McDonald's last night and you didn't bring me anything back.
Last night? McDonald's?
We didn't go to McDonald's last night. Yes, you did, Dad, because I heard you tell Mom, baby, I'm ready for that McThroat.
This one speaks to me at a level, guys. This one speaks to me at a level you cannot understand if you're not a parent. Dude, it is so hard when you have kids to, like, get your sexy on. It is so difficult, dude. Even we have a baby. We have a baby, like an 8-month-old, right? We have to, like, sneak away, close the door, and try to get it on real quickly. And the whole time, which our daughter was just like, like, she didn't care at all until we tried to get into the other room and have, like, some mommy-daddy time. And then she had the whole run of a very safe, baby-proofed upstairs. And where does she decide to hang out and play? She was playing completely happy, paying us no mind. As soon as mommy and daddy leave for some private adult time, she needs to know what's happening. She goes to the door the whole time, just starts hitting it. It's so difficult. It's the hardest thing in the world. Shout out to all my parents out there with blue balls. and blue ovaries. Shout out to my parents. You guys, babysit for your friends. It's a beautiful thing.
I want a McThroat, Dad.
Whoa.
Is it like the McDouble?
Whoa.
Can I get a McThroat with fruit punch?
Whoa.
But now when I think about it, Dad, I haven't seen the commercial for the McThroat.
Thankfully.
Is this a new sandwich?
So the object of the game is to say something that you have that the other person doesn't. So Harry, what do you got?
Some kind of cloak.
Huh, try it on. Dude, an invisibility cloak? How the hell are you gonna top that, Dom? What do you got?
I got family.
I don't get how the Fast and Furious movies are kind of cool. I don't get how they're like on number 19 though.
Baby bet, ay, couple X, ay, couple Grammys on him, couple packs, ay.
Whoa!
Put your head on my shoulder.
This girl's a queen. That is so funny. This girl's amazing. Is this her whole TikTok? Is this all she does? Like thirst traps that turn into traps? Like, this girl's awesome. This girl's so funny. Yo, that's crazy. Damn. That was like the Exorcist. What the hell? Thirst trap exorcism. That's nuts. Yo, is this her whole account? This is so cool. That's so fucking funny.
All right, ma'am. After 36 hours of surgery, it looks like your son's gonna pull through.
Oh, thank God. I was starting to get worried. The fuck did God do? I'm the one who saved him.
I know. It's just...
Nah, you know what?
Bitch.
Oh my God, stop. You're gonna kill him.
Yeah, he's about to see God real soon.
That was hell. Why is Bezos have his anthem? Why does he have a song?
Name something you can't stand.
She looks so much like my mom, guys, that it's freaking me out. She looks so much like my mother. Do I have a secret aunt? She looks so much like my mom. What the heck? I can't handle this. What?
A lot of people like, I'll go first.
What?
I can't stand.
Oh.
What you doing?
I mean, we know that eat your feet will do that. If the socks start flying off, eat your feet is that. Eat Your Feet starts playing Too Sexy by Drake and like the exact same body language. Turtleneck comes up, cigar comes out, robe on, baby. Let's go.
Hey, how you doing over there, Red Bone?
Bitch, you is ugly.
Well, damn.
All you dream about a 4G, I don't feed, now they down below. And then got so much money on me, I can't count no more. Remember I was in the project wall, couldn't even get along. Now they niggas got their...
If you get in a car accident and then you press this button, it will like undo the accident. Hope this helps.
Damn! What do these buttons do then? What services is your Tesla rendering to you with these buttons? They're taking care of your toes, and then it's toes and something above your crotch? That's beautiful. I didn't know Teslas had those capabilities. Elon sex robots win. Let's go.
And then you press this button. It will, like, undo the accident. Hope this helps.
Does the other button with the arrow from outside pointing into the car mean that that's what causes the accident? It's like, press this for an auto accident if you don't want to go to work today. Beautiful.
Please be true.
Hey!
Your friend there yet?
Yeah, he here. So what y'all trying to do? Go to the movies?
Yeah, but my friend said he's cute because she can't fuck with no lame nigga.
Yeah, he fly.
Let me see.
Let me see. What's the deal?
Hi! I'm not gonna lie, I feel like all the boys know. All the boys know. That's happened to all of us. We've all been the hi friend. Absolutely. It's a rite of passage. Some of us hit it in middle school. Some of us hit it elementary. Some of us hit it in college. Some of us, for some reason, habitually hit it and have no neurons functioning to string two or three words together into a coherent sentence to speak to the opposite sex. It happens. Ladies, I don't know. I can't speak from experience. It might be happens to you guys too. It's just your brain doesn't work sometimes. It's short circuits. It just happens. Hey. What was this? Damn!
Hey, hi. What restaurant is that?
I'm pretty sure that's just, what's the name of that podcast? I'm pretty sure that's just the podcast, right? What's it called? Oh, I can't remember. It's that podcast where the girls talk about like blowjobs with very creatively named names that sound like some super deluxe version of a vacuum. It's like, damn, if they described the Dyson the same way they described blowjobs, I would have bought like 7 Dysons. Like, it's crazy. Like, they should really think about making a lateral move and dropping merch that's just a vacuum, because that would be beautiful, right? That would be gorgeous. My podcasts on rotation are Flagrant 2. They're Flagrant 2. I've listened to Lex Friedman sometimes, depending on the guest. And those have been my only go-to since I used to listen to Rogan. He switched, though. Impulsive, again, dependent on the guest sometimes. Do y'all do podcasts? If so, I need recommendations. I love podcasts, probably my favorite medium besides YouTube, so let me know.
Baby, lock the door and turn the lights down low. Put some music on that's soft and slow.
Trash Taste? That fan's kind of sick though, isn't it?
Alright, everybody find the nearest exit. Come on, come on. Troy. Troy, what are you doing?
Officer Woods, I think I'm gonna try something.
You're gonna try something? Troy, there is a school shooter in the building. We have to go now.
I think I know a way I can stop him. Just trust me.
Is this an actual plot point from High School Musical? I didn't know there was a school shooter.
Troy, he's right.
Hey, school shooter with the big old gun. How about you drop your weapon and let's just have some fun. We're all in this together now. We can do better.
Yo, Tim and Fred, is Troy Zac Efron? Because I feel like most school shooters, if they were being serenaded from Zac Efron, how you looking at those baby blues that want to end existence, bro? I swear, if we could just port Zac Efron into any crisis situation and he could start singing and dancing with a bowl cut, I feel like that would solve most of humanity's problems. Honestly, I'm surprised Biden hasn't considered that as a foreign policy. Just drop Zac Efron into any war zone, have him start cutting a rug and singing at the enemy combatants, and I feel like we could have world peace. Have you guys seen Zac Efron? I feel like it's a pretty relatively tactical maneuver. Like, legitimately, I think it could work.
I try to save him. I try to save him.
Gay lovers find out they are brothers.
Oh, no. Is that a real headline? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, 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 no. Is that a real headline? Oh no, 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 no. Choose your character. Da 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 da. Well, they're probably gonna be what, like Fox and Wolf or something, right? Why is this such a vibe? What song is this?
Stop the cap.
Look at USA, right? 3 shooting events, 3 gold medals. Just goes to show, if you put in the work in school, you can achieve anything.
Facts, we start them young. Doc, doc, start them young. Imagine if there was a dodging event.
Now the final touch, they're gonna pour the chocolate shake into the mug, straws, whipped cream, and the s'mores brownie topping on top. Do you think you guys could finish this alone, or would you have to share?
Dude, that's just the lid. Yo, they just stacked the lid. They made it look like a Jenga tower. Is that even a drink at that point? You just put some fucking huge thing on top of another thing. Like, that's not, like, garnish. That's, like, what? I'm so confused.
What's up, guys? This is the Campfire S'mores Chocolate Milkshake from Sugar Factory in Miami Beach, Florida. It starts off with a mug dipped in chocolate. Then they build the s'mores triple-decker with a brownie.
Whoa!
What's up, guys? This is the Campfire S'mores Chocolate Milkshake from Sugar.
Tell me you're working hard at the gym without telling me you're working hard at the gym cleaning a dish.
No! Cursed hydration! That's not what water homies meant! No! Whoa, bro, those slurps were crazy. Yo, no. He slurped that up. That sounded like you mic'd up every single patron at the best Italian restaurant in the world where they're slurping normal. Brother, you are right. He was snorting. Oh, mama, I swear, I think that man has gills. He was breathing water. There's no way he was getting any oxygen. He went in. Yo, have you guys ever, what the heck? I'm scarred. I can't handle this. Dope. Yeah, that's my vibe. They don't fuck you niggas when you ain't squash this shit. Pick a bitch up, then I drop the bitch. What? Whoa!
Her arms were cut off. Her legs were cut off. Her ears were cut off. Her tongue was cut off. Her nose was cut off. Her eyeballs were plucked out. Her eyebrows were then waxed. Her tongue come off
on like what's the what? What? Girls when they watch horror movies. Oh yeah, facts.
Her arms are
I have noticed like a lot of my female friends are super into like true crime podcasts. And there's especially like there's some makeup artists that like they'll do their makeup and they'll just tell the most horrendous stories of like real life serial killers, and I'm like, I can't handle that. Serial killers scare the shit out of me, dude. I can't handle it. I get so scared. Hey, what's up, name Jasmine?
Her nose was cut off.
They're so scary.
Her eyeballs were plucked out. Her eyebrows were then waxed. Her tongue come
off on like. To me, like it's so much scarier when they're real life, and it's always like they. Everyone thought they were so cool. What you do when this man slaps your girlfriend's ass, bro? I'm gonna heel hook his bitch ass. What you gonna do with all that muscle? You can't reach and touch your own ass crack, let alone defend a leg lock. Pussy! Knees gone! You're gonna skip leg day every day, because I'm gonna break your knee! Pussy! What's up? Contact wearing pussy can't. I'm pulling guard! I'm pulling guard! Get in my guard, pussy!
Nigga come on phone like, what's the sweat? Give me the sweat.
Nah, baby, which one was it? It was him right here. Hey, what's up with you, homeboy?
What up, fool?
Hey, yeah, what's that right there?
What's what?
This. Make it.
Oh, yo. I've done this. What up, Jasmine? What up, Sky? Guys, I've done this. Critical mistake to all my boys out there. When she says she's not hungry, she means I haven't seen food yet. Once she sees the food, trust me, she's gonna be hungry. She's gonna be hungry. I protect it. I say, these are my fries. You want fries? I'll order you fries happily. You don't order fries, you're not getting any. I'm gonna ta 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 ta. No touching my fries. No touch my fries. To me. Don't talk to me. Oh! Honestly, you guys can't explain my headcanon that's not the same character from Gossip Girl. They're the same character. Same character.
Hey, do you guys smell that?
Smell what?
Smells like bitches in here. I want your energy and take control of me.
I tried to go to sleep and seen it in my dreams. What? That's nuts.
Well, what are you waiting for?
I don't know. Something amazing, I guess.
It's the worst, too, when, like, their hair's all wet and they, like, need to do the hair, but you're just going, what's up? And then you get slapped with the wet hair and it just feels like you're getting hit with spaghetti. Oh, that baby's adorable. Aw. Bitch, I be killing these beats. Damn, I got an F-16 on my body. I told a little nigga to... A little bit of Monica. That was sick. Shout out Arnav, another amazing cop. Guys, send Arnav memes. Maybe we need to make a channel on Discord for sending memes to Arnav. If you have funny TikTok, guys, funny videos, funny memes, shoot them to Arnav. Volume 3 was a massive success. I'm excited for Volume 4. Ooh, whole thing, baby. Hey, full thing, baby. Trap roll? Oh, no, I recognize that polo. Arnav! Arnav! Why?